During the previous tutorials in this series, we used the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp to define the overall route for a control valve station, then inserted all the required valves and fittings using the CS150 carbon steel pipe specification. In this tutorial, we're going to demonstrate how to use PipeDraft to edit the pipeline to minimize construction costs and optimize the layout for plant and maintenance operations. Let's examine our control station pipeline for ways that it could be improved. The first thing we notice is that the valve hand wheels are protruding into the access way along the west side of the reboiler. Let's rotate the valves so that maintenance equipment and plant personnel don't get snagged by these hand wheel stems. Before editing a pipeline, it's always a good practice to first open the group in edit mode. Since PipeDraft fitting components are owned by a SketchUp model group object, to open the group for editing, you may need to double-click it. Typically, the first click will select the group and the double-click will open the group in edit mode. This is a common SketchUp practice that you may already be familiar with. Press the space bar and double-click one of the fitting components. Notice that SketchUp has grayed out all the other model objects. This indicates the group is open for editing. Now, let's rotate those valves. Click the Transform Components command located under the Tools section of the PipeDraft palette. Click the first gate valve located on the left. Press the up arrow or down arrow key to rotate the valve around its primary centerline axis until it's in a better orientation out of the access way. Press the escape key, then click the next gate valve. Press the up arrow or down arrow key to rotate the valve until it's in a better orientation. Press the escape key, then click the globe valve located on the right. Press the up arrow or down arrow key to rotate it. That's better. The next thing we notice is that the bypass line is located a little too far from the other control valve station components. We could conserve some piping material and eliminate the need for one weld by moving the bypass T to be fitting tight against the flange at the nearest gate valve. But first we'll delete the 3-inch and 4-inch horizontal pipe segments that are in the way. Press the space bar and click the 3-inch horizontal pipe segment. Press the control key, click the 4-inch horizontal pipe segment, then press the delete key. Now, we're free to move the T and globe valve assembly. Press the space bar and draw a selection box from left to right around the T, globe valve, and the other fitting components in the assembly. Click the Transform Components command located under the Tools section of the PipeDraft palette. Click a position near the open port of the T, then click a position near the weld neck end of the flange. Press the escape key to close the transformation. Now, let's replace the missing 3-inch horizontal pipe segment. Load the PipeDraft palette with 3-inch CS150 spec components by pressing the space bar and clicking the 3-inch elbow. Click the Route Pipe command located under the Tools section of the PipeDraft palette. And click the open port on the elbow and then on the T. That's better. We could simply close up the gap in our 4-inch pipeline, but we think we can make one more improvement in our layout. When this end of the reboiler needs maintenance work, this horizontal elbow and these two pipe segments may tend to get in the way somewhat. We think we could improve this situation and also conserve a little more piping material if we reroute the horizontal pipe at a 45-degree angle. First, let's delete the fitting components we don't need. now will rotate the 4-inch elbow 45 degrees. Click the Transform Components command located in the PipeDraft palette. Click a position on the 4-inch elbow near the vertical end. Press the up arrow or down arrow key to rotate the elbow. Notice the default angle of rotation for the Transform tool is 90 degrees. Let's change it to 45 degrees by entering 45, then press the Enter key. Now, continue pressing the up arrow or down arrow key to rotate the elbow into the preferred orientation, then press the Escape key. Now, to route a pipe segment from the elbow to the centerline axis of the open port of the T, we'll need to define a temporary line of intersection. Otherwise, the angled route will overshoot the vertical plane of the control valve station. Press the L key to create a line. Move your mouse cursor to the open port on the T. Click the T when the SketchUp inferencing engine has found the center component position. You may need to rotate your view or zoom into the T before SketchUp will be able to find the position. Move your mouse cursor beyond the position of the elbow. Click a position in the model while it's aligned with the model's green-colored Y-axis. Load the PipeDraft palette with 4-inch CS150 spec components by pressing the space bar and clicking the 4-inch elbow. Click the Route Pipe command in the PipeDraft palette and click the open port on the elbow. Then click the intersecting position on the temporary line when SketchUp finds the position on edge and the segment line precisely intersects. You may need to zoom into this position to clearly see the intersection. Close the route by clicking the open port on the T. Now we can delete the temporary line. Doesn't our piping layout look much better now? That completes this tutorial. To recap, we use the PipeDraft plugin for SketchUp to edit the control valve station to minimize construction costs and optimize the layout for plant operations. Please tune in to this channel for more tutorials on how to use PipeDraft to create spec-driven three-dimensional pipelines for industrial, residential, and commercial applications using the fun and easy-to-use SketchUp Modeler. Thanks for watching.